We are live. We are going to be playing the new decks and cards and things and just saucing people, you know? Just absolutely riggedy wrecking them. So it should be fun. What we're going to start off with is Under the Sea. So I think I'm going to make a couple of changes. This is the list that I wound up with. Almost no orange cards, right? 3 Kida, 3 Big Kida, and 3 Ariel. And the only reason these are in here is to find Under the Sea, which lets you basically one-sided board clear your opponent, especially if you're resolving Kida, which is pretty nutty, because she will subtract strength from all your opposing characters. Then you get to put them all on the bottom of your opponent's deck. I tried 4, felt like too much. I tried to, so far it's felt pretty good. There's probably a good argument to go to 3. Maybe like a happy little middle ground in between. I haven't tested that yet, obviously. It's something I'm looking into. Cards I'm not too sure about yet are Hey Hey. It's been okay in testing, but there's hasn't been great. I also haven't been running into ramp, so that's something that could be holding it back a little bit. Mother Knows Best just hasn't come up. Maybe we just cut these, play a third Under the Sea, or maybe these become like Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo and we play Lucifer, something like that. I want to try more of the Muses because we haven't really gotten a chance. And the reason I want to try more Muses is there's a card I kind of forgot existed that I've seen recently, which makes me want to try that kind of build. Because the problem in these colors right now are the songs are not fantastic. So if I go to filters, orange, green, spell, because they don't have a song filter. We don't want to be playing Be Our Guest. It's a filler card. Doesn't really do anything. Part of Your World is great, but it's uninkable. Hakuna Matata doesn't do anything for this deck. Mother Knows Best, actually pretty good. That's why it's in there. That's why I'm playing two. It's good removal, especially if you pair it with Ursula. And then you can double remove stuff, which is great. So Sudden Chill works with a little discard synergy. Prince John, Ursula makes him discard 2 cards. This card also not like fantastic, but it can close out games. It can remove your opponent's hand, which is very, very good. So we like that. And World's Greatest Criminal Mind, not great. Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo could be good, but we need enter play effects, which Hey Hey kind of is, but not really. We'd want something like this to kind of bounce her and then do this again. Or we would want Lucifer. But the other problem with Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo, a lot of times you're going to need Kida to sing Under the Sea with Ariel or with Prince John or something like that. So if we're bouncing her with Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo, she has no longer dry ink, so she can no longer sing Under the Sea. So it's a little bit of like anti-synergy there, which so I don't really know how we feel about that. These are just regular actions, right? So these aren't songs. These don't help. Heal What Hasn't Hurt. Again, we're not really trying to heal. Bare Necessities, pretty good. This is worth considering. I don't think it's necessary, though, because we're just naturally playing for Ursula. And if we really want an effect like this, there's the new Shift Ursula, which I kind of want to put back in this deck because I had her in here. And for me, the Shift wasn't working, but now I think it is working. I don't know. So I might put her back in. She seems pretty good. Big problem with new Vanessa is she also gets cleaned by Under the Sea. So it's a little iffy, but maybe she can discard it, right? Because that's her effect. So I might try to put a couple copies of her back in, but we gotta watch out for our uninkable count because it's kind of high. Has Set My Heart is pretty decent if items become prevalent. It's just a good song that pops items. I tried playing it for a little bit just to have like an inkable song, and like I only ever inked it. Didn't feel good. Strike Up, good match. Same thing. Draw some cards. This card's not bad if you can find the room or if you really want the extra song count. It's pretty good. Especially with Ursula the Deceiver of All. Draw 4, drop 2, so you actually go a little plus. Outside of that, not great. Bruno's Return is pretty good, but also it's uninkable. I think this probably replaces Part of Your World. It's just better in every single way. So I don't see how you ever play Part of Your World again, because this card exists, unless you're playing, you know, 5 copies, and then you want the extra one, but I don't see it, because you don't have to, use the heal necessarily, but I'm sure it'll come up every so often, and when it does, pretty decent. Oh, it's an action. Okay, never mind. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so you play Party World because you can sing it. I did not realize that this is not a song for some reason, because it's not a song. Ah, see? Reading, kids. It's important. But yeah, all right, never mind. This card's okay, but it's not a song, so we ignore this. Look at this family. This is interesting. I played it. I didn't like it. I just inked it. Seven is, like, a lot. It's a lot of, like, if we played the four cost, the new Ariel that sings up to seven, maybe this would be a decent inclusion, because then we could just tap the one character to find two cards, as, like, draw two. But it's so slow. You basically have to have, like, Ariel and another character, and it's usually, like, Ariel Kida, Ariel Prince John. I don't want to sacrifice my Prince John by exerting him so my opponent can trade into him just to find a character. That doesn't make sense to me, so that's why we're not playing this card. It might be good. I think it costs too much and it's a little too slow. Even for Sing together, I just think it's too much. Tapping seven worth of characters is a lot. If I'm tapping that much, I want this. I want Under the Sea, because I want to clear their board, right? Like, I'll tap my whole board, and I've done that before. I've not had Ariel. I've had, like, Prince John and then, like, a 3-drop and a 2-drop, like, two Prince Johns and a 2-drop, or Prince John and Diablo and a 2-drop, and I'll turn them all sideways, clear my opponent's entire board because they just had a bunch of small characters, and pass. It's great. And also, we don't talk about Bruno. Very good. Very, very good. Usually you whittle them down. They kind of run out of cards in their hand at some point because you're discarding them and you're, like, removing their threats so they have to refill the board. And then you just pick the biggest one, and it goes to their hand and usually gets discarded because they have no cards. And then this makes Prince John live again. It's kind of like the Donald Duck and Daisy Duck combo that people were playing before, but all in one card. And it's a song. Ariel can sing it. She's really, really good. But, like I said, the reason why... Oh, see, this isn't bad either. Lost in the Woods, all opposing characters get -2. It's not bad. Cost forward a little iffy. Maybe if we played the new 2-drop Ursula to be able to sing this. And then we could pair it, but I don't think so, because the card I was actually interested in that I forgot existed is Painting the Roses Red. Up to 2 chosen characters get -1 strength, and you draw a card. This is good for trades. This is good for obviously Under the Sea, but it's also good for the Muses. And when you're playing it with Ursula, you go +1 because she can sing it twice, and then the Muses can return 2 characters to the hand. So this is the original build with Pegasus, which also been pretty good, because a lot of times Pegasus giving everybody evasive will just let you kind of quest, even with, like, your Prince John, because now he's worn and evasive for a turn, and usually they can't trade into it. He's also pretty good, because people like to play their own evasives, and he gets to take them out by trading into them. 3-3 stat line is pretty decent. We like that a lot. So I don't really want to cut him. I kind of want to increase my Kida's. 3's been fine. Maybe 4's better. Mother knows best, not necessary. Hey, not necessary. So it's possible that we cut this 6 and maybe 1 Diablo and then put in, like, the Painting the Roses Red and the extra Muses, right? So I think I'm going to start there, even though I really like this Hey. He's very good. I'm going to try that out and see how that works. And we are increasing our song count. So 1, 2, 3, 4. We can't search the Muses, which is unfortunate, but we can do this, I think. Because they don't have a name yet, so, like, they're not fully coded into the deck tracker yet. I'd like to try something like this. I would like I said, the extra Kida. Problem is I don't know what to cut. I did see a couple decks not running the Curse Merfolk, which I don't think that's correct. And I also wanted to try the... Where are you? Did I skip you? Yeah, the Vanessa. The Ursula, Eric's Bride. Pretty decent. Because you can discard some threats. You get some lore. She's pretty aggressive. Maybe we cut the Curse Merfolk in favor of this. But I don't think so. It's just the uninkable count is pretty high. We did make a little bit of room just now by cutting the 2 Mother Knows Best. So maybe we can cut, like, a Diablo. Play one of her. And then we cut one more card. Or maybe 2 more cards and try to get another I mean, like, we can cut this, we can cut the Pegasus package, but I really like it. We could cut the Pegasus package down, maybe. Maybe we go 3 and 3, and then we. Yeah, we could try that, right? We do one less of each Pegasus, one more Ursula, and then we'll try one more Kida. And we want the big one. You don't necessarily need the small Kida, because just playing this. And then Ariel plus a 3-drop is usually good enough to get this out. I would like one more, but again, I don't want to. I took the two uninkables out and put them back in. I don't want to go too crazy with the uninkables. I don't think it's wise. So we the Discord again. Aw, man, we just took Heihei out. He would be great here. All right, so we go first, which is good. We have a nice 1-2-3 curve, or three if we want it. We don't want Bruno yet. We want these two. And we definitely want Ursula. Now, this is actually a good matchup for the 4-drop Ursula, because she can discard the Quill. We don't need the Muses usually in this matchup, so we will keep it. We'll just play out our Pegasus. Also, a little iffy on this. Maybe the Queen's better, because the Queen's pretty good. Just lets you sing Bruno right away. And I'm not sure about the Bucky inclusion. We're doing this for sure. We should actually be kind of okay into this deck because we can make them discard a lot of cards. We're gonna take one jump ahead because we don't want them ramping. We just have to remember that he had to be prepared and a Flabbergasm. So probably ink this, play the Diablo, try to draw some cards and get at his hand, and then eventually like Ariel or whatever. Yeah, we don't want Bruno yet, right? So we're gonna play Diablo. Send our team in to quest a little bit. We're kind of gonna try to aggro them down here. That's kind of the idea. Okay, let's see. They have a link for stuff for you? Yeah, if you go into general chat, they're talking about it there. Which is weird. So we might have actually, because he's on 4, he's going to go to 6 this turn. We might have actually wanted to find Ursula to find, or play Ursula to find Sudden Chill with Ariel and sing it twice, but I like drawing two cards as well, because if he clears the board, we still kind of get our value out of them. So we'll see. Queen of Hearts. Yep. Oh, he could play a Medusa too to kill one of them, I guess. Which also, he could have killed the Ursula. McDuck Manor, I don't care about. Oh, that's the other card I wanted to try. I forgot about that. I wanted to try, Oh, I did get one. There was, the hell is it called? Okay, discard, you're not. Be prepared. Because you're not to. There's, bless you. Creaky. Creaky boosts the attack. Bless you. So we can go into McDuck Manor. So maybe we'll cut the Pegasus package for that. And just go after the manor. Play the full set of Kidas. Yep, get rid of Dime. Send the whole team in. Also, this is pretty good against Flavisham as well, because if he draws cards, we get to draw cards. Let's see. We're gonna draw our two. We go 3-6 next turn, and then we can try to find a thing and make him discard or whatever. So he basically has to ink and play Be Prepared, and then I get to refill. Because if he doesn't clear my board here, he's Mage. Dig, 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 dig Our opponent is confused, question mark? Okay. Yeah. I don't know why that took so long, but okay. Yeah, we don't want this Kita. So we're going to go this, this. And we could even, if he doesn't have, if he, like, plays the card in his hand, we can even, like, find Rose's red and just draw two cards. Okay. Nothing there. We'll play this one. One more. Yeah, that's the one. Bruno. I think we just pass. Because now we can Bruno the Maui, or if he plays something else, we can Bruno that, and then discard it, and then draw a card. Yeah, we don't care about that. That's fine. So we do this. Actually. Yeah, we're going to draw a card, right? So we do that. Draw a card. Oh, that's pretty good. Draw another card. Alright, that's obviously useless. Gain our lore here. We could hold this in case he top decks be prepared, but like, I don't think this two lore in our hand is going to do anything. I think we have Game of Brother, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. We're presenting lethal, so we don't need to play more cards. It's not going to do anything for us. Yeah, like, this doesn't matter. Like, if we played one of these, sure, we'd win this turn, but, like, probably win anyway. Flies. You kill my Ursula, that's mean. Yeah, we just quest with the team. We're still presenting lethal, so I still don't see a reason to kind of do anything. I guess maybe if he draws Scar specifically, we can kind of play around it by just having another character in play. Could have been one of these, but... because if he scars, it's 2, 3, 2, heal, kill this, and then he can quest for one. If he draws Be Prepared, we lose the board anyway, and then we just play two characters again, so we're good against Be Prepared at that point. It's kind of what we're holding, too. Yeah, that, we ran away with that game. So, Cricky, that's what we wanted to do.
It's the road of life, make no mistake, for me.
Yeah, a good restream by this working. Makes me happy. Giuseppe Casey, Thomas O'Malley. O'Malley, the alley cat. Alright, we go second, because we always go second. I like this. I like opening with this. I like the Sudden Chill and the Prince John. He's not in Emerald, so we can keep our songs. We don't need this. We don't need two Pegasi. So we can swap those. Well, look, it's almost like the same card. Although this into this is also very good. What the hell? Item deck, question mark? Alright, first thing we're playing is this. I am curious, actually, about Blue Steel. Oh, it's Pete Candio. He's good at the game. I just noticed. I wonder if he's running, like, Ariel OTK. Keep this for the shift line. He's aggressive, so play that. What do we got in here? Yeah, it's all items and smash. So we definitely want to play this into this. Maybe even this. We'll see. I don't think you need this, though, because you have the other cards. It's weird. Get rid of the Flynn. Play John. I don't think she's really in danger of being attacked. We're going to play another John into Sudden Chill. Draw two cards next turn. Ah, that's the card you want with this. I was lurking, I'm here for real, it was true, and some friends were able to get 1600. Nice, bro! I still want to try the new patch. Whatever T-Tar is strong, I'm happy. Yeah, it's so much card draw. Robin Hood, yeah, Robin Hood's good. I'm just so curious if he's, if he is playing the, like, OTK variant. Draw our cards. He has to be, right? Because he has more recent stuff. Alright, so now we're gonna play this. I feel like we're gonna get absolutely blown out by Grab Your Sword, but there's really not too much we can do about it. So we'll just try to collect our lore while we can. And just hope he doesn't have it. Because the only other thing I could do there is just not play this. And I still kind of get blown out by Grab Your Sword. And my goal is to shift this next turn and quest with the team. Curious. This like having this and these was nutty for him. That's why we want Forge Up Ursula to rip this away from him. Or Bear Necessities, or what's the other card? Has set my heart to crack items. I mean, he's not really. He's drawing cards, but he's not really doing much else. Nah, we don't want the Kita. We want to shift this. I think we just air rush him. Yep, we're at 18. We ink this to go to 5, I guess, and we pass. He has to hit swords. And even then, he has to clear this. He has smash, so he can smash this and play swords. And then we have just one. But the whole team being evasive is pretty nuts. Also, it would have been nice to have under the seed his board. But it's also a little bit late for that. It's just Titar is a Dragon Pulse situation. He isn't broken like people make him out to be. All I did is buff him his relevancy. I mean, that's good though. Just hangs when I add the URL for images. I did see an issue with that. Did you find the specific link, the new one? Awesome. Nice W. I'll take it. He just didn't hit swords, that's all it was. Alright. I have to say, the mutas have just not been good. Maybe it's the decks I'm playing against? I don't know. I thought they would be a lot better. Maybe I don't play enough songs. That's possible. Our song count is a little low. Maybe we do just cut Pegasus for more songs. It also doesn't help that a lot of what we're doing is discarding our songs to avoid opposing Emerald decks. So maybe that's why it's been underperforming. It's hard to say. Pegasus Shiflane is cute. See, like, I don't know. Because, like, I really like Pegasus, but, like, why would I not play this? It's just, like, I don't know, maybe Pegasus gets in there for more. Because I don't have any discard synergy, so maybe it's fine to start with this. Let's test it for science. Because he's in red steel, so I'm sure it's a lot of, like, when this character challenges type of stuff, and now he can't. Yeah, he's playing pirates. I kind of want to keep this to pair with this. But I like the discard. But I want to get this Flynn down. So it's a matter of, like, do I look for Under the Sea and try to hold this to clean his whole board? Or do I keep Pegasus and I guess I go on the aggro line because I have the option to Pegasus on 3 or 4 or whatever I want. Maybe I draw into a Prince John too and then like get some value off of this Flynn discarding a random card in his hand. Starkey! I feel like he's good. Not crazy, just okay. I mean, he's not. If you're not going to play cards, I'm just going to quest. Yeah, it's technically a song. Now the question is, am I willing to sacrifice Flynn? I'm kind of not, to be honest. Because I could protect him next turn, and I know he has access to rush characters with Jolly Roger. So I think I'm just going to pass. I'd rather like hold it to get value out of his discard effect, or try to pair Sudden Chill with Prince John and then do the Pegasus to make John evasive as well. It's hard call. Yeah, that would have gained. Gaines Rush could have swung right into that. We can take a peek at his hand. See what he's got. Hook, hook. Hook's rapier. Agrabah. Okay. I kind of just want to, like, pick his hand apart, but I guess we're just going to keep questing with Pegasus for now. He could have played the 4-drop hook, which is not a big deal. The 5-drop hook is the one we're like, kind of looking out for. Okay, Inking Agrabah is good, because until we draw Kriki, we can't remove locations. Oh, he's a 3-4. I thought he was a 2-4. See, now we need to hit Kida. Because Kida would clear this board. Alright, so we're going to do this. Everybody's evasive. Unless he somehow hits me with RLS Legacy, but I don't know how he's moving to it. Also, this is just nuts. Like, you just can't touch this board. You have to have removal. You can't attack it at all. It's so good. And then next turn, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I go to 19. Like, I don't even care if you attack at that point. Like, I don't even care if he hits these at that point, because what is he going to do? If he snuggly ducklings me, though, that's kind of spicy. No, I mean, or we could just win the game, I guess. Look at this. Look at how gross this is. It's so gross. Oh, man, your characters have no attack? Man, sure would be a shame. These. Bye-bye. So nuts. Like, what do you do against that? It's just insane. Man, it sure would be nice if you had characters, right? I don't know. Yeah. what are you supposed to do? You're like, yeah, I'll just put characters on board. He's only evasive for one turn. And then you just get absolutely blown out. I think we might want to increase this to 3. We already have 4 of this, which is great. We might want to increase this to 3. Pegasus is good. I don't know. The Muses. Oh, we're on 3 Muses. Hey, maybe we should be on 4. Maybe that's what. I don't know. How many songs do we have? Let's see. 4. 8. 10. 13. Yeah, it's kind of low. We could maybe cut something to play more songs. I have not liked this card at all. I keep trying to give it a chance, but, like, maybe if we had more songs, maybe it would be better, because then we could shift it a little bit more reliably, but, like, so far, it's felt very underwhelming, and, like, I haven't ever lived the dream where I shift her on top of the Ursula, so maybe that's why. The other problem with songs, though, is, like, there's none more that I want to play. Like, I want to play one more of this, and I kind of want to play the 4th Painting the Roses Red, so maybe we do that. We just cut these, and we play 1-1. Could try it. I don't know. Like, I feel like she's got a decent stat line. A 4-cost 2/4 is a little weak, but, like, the shift is pretty good. The Bare Necessities ability is pretty good. We just haven't drawn her when it was relevant. We'll just leave it like this for now, I guess. Orange 4-cost. No reason to change it just yet. We need more refined decks in the meta to figure out where our deck wants to line up to those, right? Like, that's kind of the idea. Alright, well, that's the deck for now. I'll probably post a link down in the comment section or something like that, so you guys can check it out, build it if you want to test it. Let me know if you're running this deck. I know a lot of people have been trying to put something like this together. Let me know what cards you like, what cards you don't like, what's been overperforming, underperforming, because there might be some spicy cards I'm missing. Maybe we need more Kriki. I didn't get to see him at all. So, definitely would have liked him a couple times. Maybe the Queen Shift package is good, too, to make somebody weaker, rather than just painting the roses red. This card also, didn't really see it too much. I don't know. Definitely need some more testing with this deck, but I want to move on to some other things. So, that'll be it for this. Now I think it's time for Sweeped. Let's get rid of this.